Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Connect Civilians. So in this lecture we are going to design a two-way continuous slab as per IS code 456 and also cross verify with our Excel sheet of design of continuous two-way slab. Okay, so this is the slab for the design. Now you will see that there is different sizes of slabs available for one house. If you assume this is the plan of your frame, okay, structure, framing structure, so this will be the line will showing you the beam, okay, and between that your slab is available. Okay, now we haven't mentioned the width of the beam here, so its dimension is from mid to mid of the beam. Okay, so now what we do, you have to also assume the width of the beam, okay, for the calculation purpose. And here are the size of the slab all given. Now we have to find the condition, boundary condition of the slab that we are going to design. Okay, now if you see this slab S1, the dimension for the slab was 3 into 4 meter, okay, and it is at the corner, so these two edges are discontinuous and this edge are continuous. Okay, these edges are continuous to S2 and S4 and these two edges are discontinuous. Okay, so what will happen according to IS code, you have to go as per table 26. So coefficient of alpha x and alpha y, you have to put the value from this table. Okay, so two adjacent edges discontinuous, so you have to take the fourth one, and according to the ratio of your ly and lx, that is effective length in y and effective length in x direction, on the basis of this ratio you have to assume the alpha x and alpha y value from these values. Okay, so these are some of the edges condition shown in table 26 IS 456. Okay, interior panel, one short edge continuous, one long edge continuous, so we are going to talk all about these conditions. So for this it is two adjacent edges are discontinuous. Okay, for this slab, if you see this slab, this edge is continuous, this edge is continuous, and this edge is continuous. For reference I will just put a line here, and this edge is discontinuous. Okay, so what will happen here, the dimension is 4 meter and this dimension is 3 meter, so your long edge is discontinuous here. Okay, so one long edge discontinuous. If you go to the table, so this the third one long edge discontinuous, so you have to follow this value for the coefficient alpha x and alpha y. Okay, from this table. Now if you go with this S3 slab, here also two adjacent edges are discontinuous, this one and this one. If you go with this S4, here only one shorter edge is discontinuous, 3.5 and 4 meter, so this is a shorter edge. So this shorter edge is discontinuous, so one short edge is discontinuous over here, and all they are continuous. For this it was a interior panel, as all the edges is continuous from both sides. Okay, so like this you have to put the conditions and give the value of alpha x and alpha y from that IS code 456 table 26. Okay, so we design slab S1 first. So here I have provided all the values for slab S1. Okay, so this is the slab S1 and these edges are continuous and these two edges are discontinuous, and we are considering the loads also, because you have to consider the load as per the structure engineer. So the live load you can take from the IS code 875 part 1 and part 2, okay, floor finish load is, we are going to take a 1 kilonewton for, it was used for floor finish, that is for tiling, and M20 and Fe415 grade we are going to use for the concrete and steel. Okay, now first you should go for the effective depth calculation. So all the procedure is same, except you have to also find the moment at support by the given coefficient. Okay, so assume you are going, so this is the total slab S1 S2. So what will happen in continuous slab if you considering the design of S1 slab? So moment at mid and span will be collected, calculated one by one, and this at span, at support, the moment will be different from S2. So you have to take the maximum value between these. Okay, if you get the moment in S1 is much lower as compared to S2, so you can also take the average of that. Okay, but if you assume that you get the 3 kilonewton meter of moment here, and from S2 slab you get the 5 kilometers, so you have to consider the maximum one. If there is variation, if it is 1 kilonewton and if it is 10 kilonewton, you can go with the average also. Okay, so you have, for design of S1 slab, you have to also go for the check of S2, S4 slab. Okay, from that you can also get the support moment of here, and for S, from S4 you can also get a support moment of here. Okay, so now we will go for design S1 slab first. So now consider the effective depth. We have to calculate the effective depth first. So what will be the LX? That is 3 meter here. Okay, for design you have to always consider the shorter span. Okay, of slab, the live load was 4 kilonewton, this will be greater than 3 kilonewton per meter square. So here our formula for the effective depth of X calculation will be L by 26 into modification factor. So this is the basic value for the continuous slab. Okay, so assume if this is less than 3 kilonewton and less than 3.5, so value will be different for the basic. Okay, so its value is varies between 30 to 40 26. Okay, depending on the steel and the total live load that is occurring. Okay, so I have already told this in my previous lecture where I have designed this Excel sheet, so you can go and check, so you will find out how this value will be taken. Okay, here we are going to take the value directly. So our effective depth is equal to L by 26 into modification factor. So basic value into modification factor. So we have, from finding the modification factor, we have to consider the percentage of steel. So I'm going to consider as 0.4. So you can consider up to 0.2 to 0.6, whatever you want to. Okay, so I'm considering as 0.4%. Now Fy is 415. So this value, from these values your Fs will be calculated. Okay, Fs is equal to 0.58 into Fy into steel provided, for steel required upon steel provided. Okay, so this will be the formula. So we haven't provided any steel here, so you can take these values as 1 for initial value. Okay, so if you multiply this 0.58 into Fi is our 415, so you will get around 240, okay? So from the IS code only, for the tension reinforcement. So this will be the graph for the calculation of your MF, modification factor value. So it will come around 240 here. So FS will be given here, and we have considered the percentage 0.4. So if we follow the line and we'll go with like this, our FS value will be assumed as 1.35, around 1.35, okay. So this is not a correct value for the initial assumption of effective day. You can go with this, okay. This is the pattern for initial effective depth, okay. So you can assume the effective depth more than that, and can design, after designing you can get the accurate effective whether it is passing or not, okay. So our MF is taken as 1.35 from the graph. Now so in the formula we can put it 3000 divided by 26 into 1.35. 3000 is our effective span upon 26 into 1.35. just take the effective span for more accurate or safe calculation, okay. So our value effective depth in x direction will be calculated as, that is shorter direction will be calculated as 85.5 mm. So we can take the effective depth of shorter direction is equal to 100 mm, okay. So we have to consider the more value than calculated, okay. Now we have to also assume the diode, the bar that we are going to use in the design, okay. Now from the, so our total depth will become 100 is the effective depth for x direction, plus diode bar divided by 2 up to the center of the bar, plus cover that we have to provide, to 20. So our total effective total depth of slab will be calculated at 125, and effective span calculation, so our clear span will be calculated as our beam width was not mentioned, so we are going to consider the beam width of the beam of 230 mm, okay. Now clear span is equal to 3000 is our clear span of shorter direction minus 230, that is beam width, okay. So our clear span will be calculated as 2770, okay. Now so it will be from center to of one support to other support, okay. So center to center of the support will be the effective depth, as you know. So two value will be taken. Now we have also got the effective depth, and also also know the center to center of the span. So this is the clear span 2770. Now we have to check whether our support is less than 1/12 of the clear span or not. So this is mentioned in IS code 456 on page number 35. You will see here in effective span B. So in continuous beam of slab, if the width of the support is less than 1/12 of the clear span, the effective span shall be as 22.2. So if width of the support is less than 1/12, we have to use by this method, that is center center or the clear span plus the effective depth, whichever is lesser. If it is not less than 1/12, then we have to consider it by this method, okay. So we can check. Generally it will be less in the calculation, but if it is not, then you can follow this. If the support are wider than 1 meter of the clear span or 600 mm, whichever is lesser, the effective span shall be taken at the end span of one fixed end and the other continuous. Okay, so you can go with this also if the width was not less than 1 meter, the clear span. Okay, so here our clear span is 2770 and our 1 by 12th, you will divide it by 12, so it will come as 231. So it is without the support, my without the support is 230, so our without support is less than 1 by 12th of the clear span, then that is okay. Now it is a, so its value is just an equal value, but we can take it as okay. If it is not, then you have to again design the effective span by second method. So we have to go with clause 22.2, that was the first clause from this. Okay, so our effective span is 2770, clear span plus effective depth is for shorter direction is 100, so 2870, and 2770 plus center to center of the center beam of width of the beam on both the sides, so it will be taken as 230 by 2, so it will total will be 230, it is 3000 mm. So we have to take the lesser value between these, so our LEX is calculated as 2870 mm. Okay, so similarly for LY direction we can do, so our value will come as 3860, so our DY will be calculated as, that is effective depth in Y direction for longest span will be effective depth of shortest span minus diameter bar, so it will come as 90 mm. Okay, so our effective depth of both the direction will be calculated and effective span is also calculated. Now what we will do, so we can go with the calculation of loading and bending moment. Okay, so our self weight for according to our slab thickness will be 125 into 25 into 1 meter for 1 meter of width, so it will come at 3.125 kilonewton per meter. Floor finish we have taken as 1 kilonewton per meter and live load is considered as 4 kilonewton per meter, so total load will be calculated as 8.125 kilonewton per meter. So if we go with the ultimate load, so it will multiply by 1.5 into 0.125 kilonewton per meter, and it is calculated as 12.2 kilonewton per meter. So our moment calculation will be done by the finding the effective ratios for both. It will be also called as R. So if you go with LEX, LEY by LEX, so 3.86 upon 2.87 will be calculated as 1.34. The ratio for both the effective spans, so according to this effective span values 1.35, you have to take the value from the table that is present, also present the IS code I have shown you earlier. Okay, so I have made the table separately here. Now our ratio will come as 1.35. okay, so here it is 1, so this will be the ratio, and 1.1 1.2 1.3, so our value will come in between 1.3 and 1.4, so you have to do the interpolation here, so our value will be equal to 1.34. okay, so what we have done here, so you have to put the lesser and higher value of that, so 1.3 we have taken here and 1.4 we have taken in interpolation. Alpha x positive and negative and alpha y positive and negative value will be taken from this table, so it is taken towards the discontinuous, so table will be arrived here and you have to take the alpha x alpha value from this table. So for 1.3 you have taken as alpha x is the positive moment at mid span, alpha x positive, so positive alpha x and negative positive alpha will be at mid, and positive negative alpha x and negative alpha will be at supports. Okay, so it is positive, so it, alpha x value will be 0.049 for 1.3. similarly for 1.5 it is 0.053, so it was written here. Okay, you have to fill this value from this table. Okay, for the interpolation. Now for alpha x negative, so you have to take the value from this, so 0.065 and 0.071 here, and alpha while positive and negative will be taken automatically by this table. You don't have to do anything. Okay. So now these 1.34 for alpha x, positive, negative value will be calculated. So we have also calculated here, and this is the formula for the moment calculation at shorter and longer span. So mx is equal to alpha x into w l x square, and for longer direction it is my is equal to alpha y into w l x square. You have to consider the effective length of shorter span for both the moment calculation. Okay. So our ratio is 1.34. for interpolation by that better you can get the alpha x positive negative value like this. So it was mentioned in page number 41, case 4. Okay. Yes, 4, 5, 6. If you don't know how to do the interpolation, you can check my previous video of restraint lab. I have already told how to do. Okay. Now, we go with the moment calculation. So, I have shown here how it was calculated. So, it will be a shorter direction and it is a longer direction. So, alpha x positive will be here like this, and alpha y positive value will be, so alpha x positive will be used for the shorter direction moment, and alpha y positive will be used for the longer direction at mid response. Similarly, for negative, here we have to use alpha x negative, and for alpha y negative, we have to use in longer direction. Okay. So mx positive will be calculated by the formula alpha x positive into w into lx square. So alpha x positive will be calculated 0.051, load will be 12.2 into 2.87 is our effective length. So our value is calculated 5.1 kilonewton. So it is applied here. Okay, alpha x in place of alpha x. So our 5.1 kilonewton per meter is moment at mid span for shorter direction. Okay. Similarly for alpha x negative, we have to put all the values and we will get 6.8 kilonewton meter, and this value will be here. Okay. If this is not continuous, so you don't have to assume any value here, but for the continuous you have to assume this. Okay. If it is not continuous, you can go with the 6.8 directly. That was not a problem. But at continuous, you have to match both of the value of another slab with the maximum value you have to take. Okay. So alpha y positive will be calculated as 3.5, and alpha y negative will be calculated as 4.72 by the formula. Okay. So all the moment is calculated, and by that you have to go with the steel calculation. Okay. Now we have done here, and we have calculated the moment, how to calculate the moment. So, and here also we have mentioned the same slab, and we are going with two adjacent discontinuous. All the value will be taken from as same as our manual design. So our effective depth will be calculated for x direction, that is for the lower portion, was 50 mm by the formula. So this will be okay because we have provided 100 mm. Here it is okay, and our tension reinforcement will be calculated in this. Okay. So here if you see the tension reinforcement. So our steel will be calculated by this moment that we have calculated here. Here we have calculated. The value will be same, 5.1. Here if you see in these tables, four tables. So our mx positive will come as 5.1, that was equal. Our mx negative will come as 6.8, that is also correct. Mx my positive is 3.5 and y negative was 4.72. So 3.5 and 4.72 moment will be calculated correctly. Now if you come here, you will see the depth check and it is coming as 20. This will be also okay. So if you don't know how to calculate the depth, you can go and check my distance lab video. You can get all the step how to find the depth and how to find the reinforcement. Similarly, for the calculation of steel, you have to just provide the value from this, that is mx at midpoint. So for x and y, this value is taken from table 5.1, or you can directly go the for the maximum value between these. Okay, or if you don't want to go like this, you can take the value differently. That is, for moment in x direction is positive, that is mid span will be calculated 5.1. So according to that, our ST for main bias calculated as 0.15%, that is 146. But our ST minimum is 150, so you have to provide the ST minimum in this. Okay, and our spacing is calculated as 523, but we don't have to provide more than 300. Okay, or 3 into effective depth, whichever is minimum. So minimum maximum spacing is 300, so you can't provide more than this 300. Okay, similarly, this is for the distribution. If you want to consider, now we are going to provide for steel here. So if you go with that 10 mm diabar that we have taken for effective depth, and we are going with 300 spacing, so our steel will come as 261, and here our ST will be calculated at 150. Okay, so what will happen? So at support, what will happen, the spacing between two bar at top will become double, that is 600 mm. Okay, and if you go with the calculation of at support moment, okay, so mx negative, so you have to give the value for support also, because moment is calculated differently here. And our ST will be calculated 196 for the support moment. And here what will happen, this area of steel is already provided at support from the main reinforcement. Okay, so we have to provide the ST around 65 mm square, that is whatever steel is left after subtracting this value, because it is already present there. Okay, so our value will be taken as, if you also, we have to also decrease the spacing, because we don't have to provide the more than the 300 spacing. Okay, so this is the requirement for the main reinforcement on slab. So you don't go spacing of more than 300. So what you have to do, either you can decrease this value by increasing or by decreasing this spacing. Okay, directly if you go with 150 here, then here will be spacing will become a 300, so this will be the maximum spacing that is allowed to provide. Okay, so you can directly go with this value, and according to this, your developer length at corner will be calculated. Okay, so you can do like this also, or either you can go with like this. It was the mid span steel that is provided, and it was extended to the support here, and here you have also provided the at 300, so our area will be come as 130, so it is much more than 65 mm square. So you have to provide an extra bar at supports. Okay, like this, you can go with like this also, by not increasing your main reinforcement but also providing the extra bar at support. So they are the, we have shown you two methods to do, whichever you like to do. Either increase your main bar so it will directly decrease your spacing at support also. That is maximum you have to provide say 300. If it is not okay, it will show you not okay. Okay. And if you don't want to increase your main bar, then you have to increase in only support bar. So you have to provide extra support bar. All you need to do is to provide the spacing in multiple of this. That is, if it is 600, then you have to provide it at 300. So your support spacing will also be decreased to 300. Okay. So similarly for Y, you have to do like this. Okay. So here it is taken for positive value, and here it is taken for negative value at support moment on both sides. So you can go with this also. According to this, your development length will be calculated at the corners of the support. Always remember that. Okay. So this Excel sheet I will provide with the video. I have already given the link of the Excel sheet in my previous class, where I have defined all this, all the how it is made, all the value how it is taken. Okay. So you can easily calculate the reinforcement after calculating the moment. Okay. So I have shown you how to design your first slab. So in next lecture, in next part, we will design the S2 slab and we will see the reinforcement calculation over there. So if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.